Is this scary? Let's try another view. Is this scary? Keep watching the video and see not only what was scary about this machine, but also what was dangerous. This is the IMA stereo system by Craig. So you could say, I'm a Craig. We're going to see one of the first things about this machine that's scary. And it's easy to show you. Let me turn this around. There are 18 screws that hold the mechanism to the faceplate. That's scary. Especially since they were not color-coded to indicate which ones held the mechanism to the case and which ones held the mechanism together. The other thing about this machine that was scary and dangerous was what had happened to the power supply. This is a 117 volt to 12.6 volt step-down transformer. This is a new transformer which I purchased at Radio Shack, and it is shielded. It also has a fuse. When I got this machine, the power transformer was this unit here, and it was running hot. And this was the fuse holder that they had put in. Now, this is a repair job that somebody had done. And the fuse holder was floating just by the wires inside the unit. Now, if you notice, there's no insulation whatsoever. This is a very dangerous type of fuse holder to use unless it is fixed to the chassis in a very safe place. What we have here is a digital clock, a radio tuner section, an amplifier section, and a cassette drive system. So this makes a complete stereo system. The clock itself had a few problems with it, and cleaning the switches helped. The dimmer on the clock still does not work. I don't know why. The radio tuner section is in perfect condition. It's absolutely beautiful. The cassette mechanism needed a lot of work, and that's what we're going to look at because it's a tape recorder, and Clydesight Channel is all about tape recorders. This mechanism is very unique. I've never seen anything designed quite like it. We have the motor located here, and it's different from many machines because the motor is actually facing the opposite direction that you would see in a normal cassette recorder. The body of the motor is actually towards the front of the machine instead of towards the back. The motor turns clockwise, and as it turns, this belt wraps around this plastic pulley, then comes down, fishes through the space that holds the back of the capstan, and then wraps a little bit around the pulley, and then returns back to the motor. Now, they did something kind of interesting here. They put this piece of green felt. I don't know if that's original or if that was something that the person who had put in that transformer added to reduce belt flutter. The second thing that we see here is this pulley, which runs over here, and this is where the tape counter is. We'll see that in a moment. It looks like it's being driven by the rim of the capstan flywheel. In actual fact, it's just below the edge of the rim, and it's just off the rim, so it doesn't touch it. It's actually driven by the take-up table. This little switch here activates the motor, so this is how it actually runs. Now that switch is activated whenever any of the function controls are pressed down. The pulley does all the work. It is not a friction clutch mechanism as you would see in a Norelco or Sanyo type of mechanism. They handle things differently, as we'll see when we look at the front. But watch the action. I'm putting it in rewind. Notice that in rewind it pulled over a little bit, stretching the belt slightly. Now watch and fast forward. Notice that it moved in this direction, loosening the belt slightly. Now put it in play. Notice that it also moved in this direction, loosening the belt slightly. So the tension on this belt is very important. Let's take a look at the front of it and you'll understand more how this works. The other side of the white pulley is located here. It's a little pulley with a rubber tire on it, and it has two steps. One is the tire and one is this little axle here. Now this engages either of these two rubber pulleys for take up and fast forward, and it engages the feed spindle for rewind. Let's look at rewind. And you can see how it came over and it is spinning this table. Now let's look at fast forward. In fast forward, the pulley presses against this idler, which presses against the lower part of the take-up spindle, which has direct connection with the upper part of the spindle so that there is no loss of motion. Now in play, it's slightly different. The upper part of this pulley presses against this idler, which turns the upper part of the take-up spindle, and that has the friction clutch, which allows for take-up and playback. And here is the entire mechanism with the tape counter, the motor, and of course the head assembly. It's an electric erase head, of course, stereo cassette record playback head, capstan and pinch roller, and it does have a mechanical pause control. So there it is in play, and the mechanical pause control disengages it from play, as you would expect. However, let's put it in fast forward. We've got a nice fast forward going, but watch what happens when I put it in pause. Yes, and pause will also stop fast forward. This machine has no brakes on it at all. It depends on the tension of the belt to the tape counter to provide braking on this side, and there is a spring underneath this spindle to provide braking on this side. The entire drive system is concealed by this plate. We have the entire mechanism and electronics back in the wooden case for the Craig, and so here we see the transformer, under here is the fuse, here is a coil of wire going to the speaker, here's another coil of wire going to the speaker. I put clips on the speakers so you can snap them off instead of trying to get the speakers out and then take the chassis out. Now obviously we're not going to leave the back of it open like that because that's dangerous, so they have this board, which is a type of homosote, and you can see the UL approval badge here, and that's Underwriters Laboratory, which does extensive testing on equipment like this to make sure it's safe. And then there are screws, 1, 2, 3, that go here to lock it in. It locks into slots in the bottom of the case here for the bottom part. And here we can see why I call this IMA CRAIG, because it says IMA, a CRAIG company. And CRAIG, of course, is made by Sanyo. If we move over just slightly, we can see it is the model number PS2000. We have a ground screw here, an antenna screw here, which works with the AC power cord, phono right-left, auxiliary right-left, tape out right-left, and external speaker right-left. The phono is for a ceramic type cartridge, not a magnetic one. And there is no switch on the front for the phono, so when it is put in auxiliary, it will either take from the auxiliary or the phono, and I suppose if you had both hooked up, both would feed in at the same time. Here is the front of the unit, and we can see the cassette door here, and the controls: record, rewind, fast forward, play, stop, eject, and pause. Here we have left and right microphone inputs, the master control switch, push it to on and everything functions, or off, turns everything off, radio, and tone. These are for the alarm system, so it'll either play the radio or it'll play a beep. External speaker switch, snooze switch, tone, balance, volume, the selector switch, AM, FM, FM multiplex, tape, and auxiliary. Here is your tuning dial, indicator for record, for when the tape recorder is recording. No meters, it's an automatic level system. Here's the digital counter, here's the radio dial, and a stereo indicator on the radio dial. The clock section simply has alarm, sleep, seconds, time set with fast and slow, and that also works with the alarm, fast and slow, it'll set as well. And up here is a dial that is supposed to dim the display here, but it does not function, and I'm not sure why. So let's put it into on, and we will go to the FM. And when it's in the FM, you can see the stereo light came on, and this is a lighted dial. Turn it off. See how the light goes out. Here is the rewind function. Here is fast forward. And here is play. Pause. Turn the volume off. Release the pause. Stop. All of these functions can switch from one to the other. For the test recording, I'm using my Radio Shack stereo microphone. To do that, we push down pause, push down the record button, and then the play button. And now we're ready to make a test recording. We don't have to set any switches here, it's all automatic. Testing, 1, 2, 3, 4, testing, 1, 2, 3, 4, testing the IMA stereo system, IMA CRAIG. Channel 1, channel 1, channel 1, channel 2, channel 2, channel 2. Both channels, both channels, both channels. This is the end of the test. And then we press the stop button. So I take my microphone away, and I rewind the tape, and we put it on play. Testing, 1, 2, 3, 4, testing, 1, 2, 3, 4, testing the IMA stereo system, IMA CRAIG. Channel 1, channel 1, channel 1, channel 2, channel 2, channel 2. Both channels, both channels, both channels. This is the end of the test. So, it does a very good job of recording through the line input. It does a very good job of recording through the microphone input, nice and clear, AC bias, obviously. It also feeds out through the external speakers, and it also records from a ceramic phono cartridge. All of this has been tested and it all works. It is a nice addition to the clydesight collection. Thank you for watching this video on the IMA CRAIG stereo system, cassette recorder with radio and alarm clock. Please continue watching Clydesight Channel for more vintage tape recorder videos. And don't forget to visit us at the Vintage Tape Recorder Hall of Fame, where this machine, as well as many other tape recorders, appear with photos, specifications, and videos. Bye-bye now.